A very warm good morning to one and all present over here class. Welcome to the digital platform of APS. Now this is Pawan Kumar. Today I will discuss some questions related to derivative. So class, in previous lecture I have completed the questions related to derivative also. So in this lecture I will discuss some smart questions related to derivative. So see. Differentiate the function. Question is, find the derivative of the function using first principle. Find dy by dx of y is equal to sin x upon x using FPM. Using first principle method. This is FPM. So see, first of all, what we have to do? Now given function is y is equal to sin x upon x. You know, this is given. Now see the solution. Given function fx is equal to sin x upon x. So clearly from fx plus h, from fx we can write f of x plus h. So what we can write, f of x plus h, this implies f of x plus h we can write sine of x plus h whole upon x plus h. So fx and f of x plus h, it is clear. Now we have to write the formula of first principle method. Since f dash x, what we can write? Limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus fx whole upon h. Now we are going to put its value f of x plus h and f of x. So result, limit h tends to 0 sine of x plus h whole upon x plus h minus sine x upon x and whole upon h. Now after taking LCM, you know, LCM of LCM in numerator. So f dash x result, limit h tends to 0 x sine x plus h minus x plus h sin x whole upon x into x plus h into x. Now you can see, and when you will multiply, or this format, what we can write. So see, you will multiply by sin x, so result you will get, I'm writing here, so f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0, this is x time sine of x plus h minus x time sine x minus h sine x whole upon h into x h plus x. Now see, now from this expression we can take x common. So after taking x common, what you will get the result, you will see f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 x time sine of x plus h minus sine x whole upon h into x into x plus h minus h sine x. So see, this one we have to separate. Now after separating, what we will get the result, limit h tends to 0 sin x plus h minus sin x whole upon x time, this is h with h plus x because x part will cancel. So with negative sign, h sine x upon h into x plus h. Now this one we have to operate here formula sin c minus sin d. Now sin c minus sin d means limit h tends to 0, 1 upon x plus h is common, you know, and this h will cancel, and this one we can write to cos 2x plus h by 2 into sin this minus this by 2. So here will be h by 2 whole upon होल अपॉन दिस इज एच माइनस साइन एक्स अपॉन एक्स ब्रैकेट क्लोज्ड वन अपॉन एक्स प्लस एच. सो दिस वन आई एम सेंडिंग हियर. नाउ व्हाट वी विल गेट द रिजल्ट. Result will be, when you will operate, this result will be 1 and this result will be cos x. So cos x minus and this result will be 1. So what we can write? Here when you will operate result, you will get this is cos x. So cos x upon x, this result will be cos x upon x. Now minus sin x whole upon x square or x plus h, what we can write when you will operate limit. So this will be 1 upon or sin x whole upon x square. Now we can write this result is cos x upon x. This result is cos x upon x. Now with negative sign, this result is sin x upon x square. Now after taking LCM, what you will get the result? We will get x cos x minus sin x whole upon x square. Now this is the answer. This is the answer. This is the result after taking the limit. Now you can see, or this one we have taken common. So directly I can write here x plus h with x plus h here. No need to take common. Now you can operate this limits. Now see, again see what I have done in this question and what is given in this question. In this question, this is given function y is equal to sin x upon x. Now we have to find the derivative using first principle method. So in this question, first of all, you have to write the similar f of x and f of x plus h function according to y is equal to sin x upon x. Now f of x and f of x plus h we have written in this question in previous display. Now when you will put f of x plus h, f of x value, and now you will take LCM. After taking LCM, you will see this expression will come. And after taking x common, you will see this result. This is the result. Now we have to separate and sin c minus sin d formula we have to operate here. Sin c minus sin d result is 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. And x will cancel out, so h time x plus h and hx time x plus h in numerator of h sin x. Now formula we have written and this 2 will transfer in the denominator of the denominator. Now after taking limit, this will 1 and this will cos x upon x and this will sin x upon x square. Now this part is completed. Now I will come to the next question. The next question is, using FPM means first principle method, find dy by dx where y is equal to x square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2. Now this is the question and we have to solve using FPM means first principle method. Now in this question we have to write given function fx is equal to x square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2. This implies we can write f of x plus h. Now f of x plus h result is x plus h whole square plus 2 whole upon x plus h plus 2. Now see, now f dash x we can write limit h tends to 0. This result is x plus h whole square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2, x plus h plus 2. This is x plus h plus 2 minus x square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2 whole upon h. Now we have to take LCM. So f dash x result we can write limit h tends to 0. We have to take LCM. So result will be x plus 2 in curly bracket x plus h whole square plus 2 minus x square plus 2 in bracket x plus h plus 2 whole upon x plus h plus 2 with x plus 2. Now when you will multiply, what you will get the result? You will see after calculation, or this is the expansion, x square plus 2hx plus h square. Now limit h tends to 0. This is x plus 2. This is x square plus 2 or h square plus 2 x h plus 2 whole upon x plus h plus 2 x plus 2 minus sign. This result goes to x square plus 2 with multiply by x plus 2 plus x square plus 2 with h. See, Now, see the next steps. The next step is f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0. This result, suppose we are going to multiply, result will be x plus 2, now x square plus 2, x square plus 2, suppose you are taking in bracket, and now again plus x plus 2 with h plus 2x, h plus 2x with h. Directly I am writing minus sign, this result will be negative because minus sign is outside the integral differentiation part. So minus x square plus 2 with x plus 2 minus h time, minus h time x square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2 plus h, or x plus h plus 2 with x plus 2. Now this result is cancelled. Now h you can take common, and in denominator result is also h. So result will be f dash x, result will be limit h tends to 0, h, suppose you are taking common, so x plus 2, h plus 2x minus x square plus 2, this will outside the bracket suppose, and whole upon now this term is cancelled, you know, and the result is x plus 2 h time x plus 2 h plus 2x, and minus h also I have taken common, whole upon x plus h plus 2, now x plus 2. Now you can see yes, 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 cancel. Now suppose you are putting the limits, so what you will get the result? Now result you will see, when you will put the limit, this result will be 2x. So 2x time x plus 2 means x plus 2 limit h tends to 0, h plus 2x minus x square plus 2 whole upon, this result goes to x plus 2, x plus 2. Now this one we can write x plus 2 with the 2x. Here I am writing. So 2x time x plus 2 minus x square plus 2 whole upon x plus 2, 2 times will be means x plus 2 whole square. Now result what we can write? Result you will see, this is 2x square, this is 4x, and this is minus x square minus 2. So expression will be 2x square minus x square and now plus 4x and now minus 2 whole upon x plus 2 whole square. X plus 2 whole square. Now this is the answer. You can see x square plus 4x minus 2 whole upon x plus 2 whole square is the answer. Now this is completed.